Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Forever, forever, forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
O now and ever, and in the age of ages. Amen. O Lord, our merciful Lord, the ever present and ever glory of the present and glory of God, our many and many creation, fulfilled with the oldest man for our hearts of the evening testimony, and gathered with them in the dark and with humanity, consequently, by all faithful again, by the body of the Son, the faith of the grace, and all of my wisdom, the empire of heaven and heaven, and the reign of the world, speaking of us and control of us, against the ascending and the fallen of the world, and the God of the King, that we have sent to us, for us, and we have made the abomination of the temple. I sit delivered up in the temple, forth and I sit from me to party. And bread and tea, O Lord, will be on our stretch and on our to lead me to the temple of our city. Or shall this be the grace of our father? But they may give thanks to the great day, shall end in the grace of our father, the day of the truth, and the day of destruction. They shall not receive our full darkness in our eyes, and in our lives to come. But as we enter the O Lord, our God, the morning shall our hands bear from before thee, for through a void without past, 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 all of them. Grant thy faith, Lord, for me, a poor man, a lion, and shall look to me as they have been exalted out of some of the promises of death. And very time back to poverty, and I dare that glory shall be me. We came around to God, and I brought our own goodness to save all my promises near by. Together thou hast been with the Lord, and my friends, and they shall not have been with you, because of my enemies. O Lord God, my salvation, the day I cry, my night before thee, for thy prayer comes before thee, and all my hands and my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all thine understanding, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all thine understanding. Through the graciousness of thine, and the peace of God, and the Lord, 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 and the
to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all-holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thank you. Let them have your life, if you're very willing, yes. For us, my friend, I love for the invitation. Or for the earthly, or 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 the earthly,
life unto Christ our God. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
Cast the net on the right side of the boat, and you will find some. So they cast it, and now heard that it was the Lord, he put on his clothes, for he was naked, and sprang into the sea. But the other disciples came in the boat, dragging a net full of fish, for they were not far from land, but about 100 yards off. When they got out on the land, they saw a charcoal fire lying there with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish that you have just caught." So Simon Peter went aboard and hauled the net ashore, full of large fish, 153 of them. And although there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, dine." Now none of the disciples dare ask him, "Who are you?" They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them, and so did the fish. And this was now the third time that Jesus was revealed to the disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee. In that we have beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Holy Lord Jesus, the only Son of God, thy prophecy and joy of Christ, and thy holy resurrection, praise and glorify. For thou art our God, and we know that it is by thee. We call upon thy name, O come, all ye faithful, and to glorify for the resurrection. For those of the Father's joy are coming to all the world. Ever blessed the Lord that has seen his resurrection, for in that he endured the cross for us, he has destroyed death by death. And in him you have also been made faithful, and the Lord will be glorified by the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit. For now, my nation, my sin, and 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 my sin,
and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and my sin, and Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentapolis, the Wonder Workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Merce Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, God-Bearer of Antioch, Arlampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Nastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fertini, Marina, Pereska, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and godly brothers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy fathers slain at Sinai and Raphael, Virgin Martyr Agnes, the venerable Theodulus, the son of Nellus, the wise of Sinai, Nina, equal to the apostles, and enlightener of Georgia, and Sabas, the first Archbishop of Serbia, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, would be saved, the most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee, have mercy upon us.
Thank you.
our God.
Oh,
the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord. City, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all-holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, Ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Most blessed and glorious, Lady Theotokos. our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
he withdrew into Galilee. And leaving Nazareth, he went and dwelt in Capernaum by the sea, in the territory of Zebulun and Naphtali, that what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. The land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali toward the sea, across the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and for those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to preach, saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand."
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Almost immediately after being baptized by John from the Jordan, our Lord began his public ministry of preaching and teaching, saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." For the next 3 years, he would continue to repeat this message in one form or another through parables, through teachings directly, always speaking of the need for repentance and always centering on the kingdom of heaven. All the parables and all the stories that Jesus told, usually in some way focused on the kingdom heaven. He spoke of repentance because we are sinners. Simple as that. Our fallen nature, left unchecked, leads us ever farther away from God, and with every thought, every word, every deed which comes to us so naturally from out of the dark side of us. Repentance, you know, is not merely saying that we're sorry for this or acknowledging our sins, but it involves a turning and moving in the opposite direction, ahead toward God. Repentance is therefore not a one-time action, but the continual movement of the human person toward his full redemption in Christ. If we understand that, then we understand what Christ meant. Repent, not just now, I mean only, but live repentance, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Of course, he spoke of the kingdom of heaven, because that is the realm in which the redeemed live. It is not a place in the clouds, like many people think. Heaven is up there somewhere. It is here, at hand. Everywhere where Jesus is, there is his kingdom. Where you find the king, you find his kingdom. So Jesus didn't say the kingdom of heaven is high in the sky. By and by, he didn't say it's the place where you go when you die. He said the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's here now revealed. He came to usher in that kingdom, the beginning of the kingdom. To be fulfilled, yes, and completely later, but established here now. And so, where do we enter that kingdom of heaven? Right here. When do we enter the kingdom of heaven? Right now. And how do we enter the kingdom of heaven? By repentance. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And so the prayer of Manasseh, which comes out of the Fuller Canon, the so-called Apocrypha, which we read also during the Compline service, says, "Thou, O Lord, according to thy great goodness, hast promised repentance and forgiveness to them that have sinned against thee, and of thine infinite mercies has appointed repentance unto sinners, that they may be saved." It is by repentance. You see, we must never focus exclusively on forgiveness as the means of our salvation. God forgave, so we're saved. We must also accept the gift of repentance, because that is also part of the gift that God gives. He's provided us together repentance and forgiveness for the salvation. And this takes place entirely in the kingdom of heaven. That's where it happens.
You know, in addition, the kingdom of heaven is a community. It is an ecclesia, a gathering of people called out from the world to live in communion with one another in Christ, in his body, the church. At this very moment, we may be in Costa Mesa, but we are also together assembled in Christ as members of his body and in the kingdom of heaven, standing before the very altar of God. It's important for us to remember these things, the fact that repentance is really the best way to define it is the Christian life. That's just what it is. Every deed that you do properly, righteously in the Christian life is repentance. So it's not like a negative thing. So often people think repentance means I'm sorry, but that's not what it's about. I mean, if we're sorry, that's good. But still, we need to do what is right. And it's important also to remember, yes, that we are part of a community. It's not just me and God, but it's, you know, God doesn't save individuals. Scandalous thought, especially in a culture that, you know, it's all about me and Jesus. But God saves his body, the church. He shows us the image of the ark. That's the saving of many people together. And if we forget that, you know, it's usually when we're alone. I guess it's easy enough to remember when we're all sitting here together, you know, one with one another, but it's when we're alone that we forget that we're connected, that we forget that our salvation is part of a communal experience. And it's often when we fall into our worst sins, right, when we're alone. I mean, practically, I don't think too many folks are sitting here. I don't see anybody sitting here right now looking at porn on their cell phone. You know, unless you're really subtle about it. But when you get home and when you're alone, it may be a different thing, right? I mean, you know, it's like when we're together, we're not going to sin. When we're apart, we forget. You know, your secret sins are bad. But we sometimes, I think, mistakenly think that they only affect us. They only affect me. You know, it's my business if I'm angry with somebody. Doesn't affect anybody at church. Well, guess again. Yeah. I mean, that's what the scriptures and the traditions and the teachings of the church tell us. The body of Christ. Poison the toe and the whole foot gets sick. And if the foot, then the leg. And if the leg, then you know what else. I mean, it goes on from there. Consider the prodigal son also, who's, you know, it's just going to be really short couple weeks when we teach on him again. But after squandering the inheritance that had been given to him, which, by the way, was the family inheritance, his portion, his share, but it was part of what made the family strong. And it weakened the family for the father to give that up to the son, and especially when he went out and blew it on, you know, wine, whiskey, and women, and the rest of it he just wasted. But, you know, he returned to his father. And he said, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. And you know, he was really, really right. When he had come to his senses, something clicked. And for the first time, maybe in his life, he got it. His sins impacted himself terribly. He lost his inheritance. He wasn't going to get it back. It was gone. But also, his sins impacted his family. His father, his brother, his whole family. And we want to go there, really, all mankind. Because the sins of every person affect us all. It's like the stone tossed into a little pond. I mean, the ripples go out, they disturb the entire pond. And even heaven. I have sinned against heaven and against you. You know, everything that heaven stands for, the goodness, the purity, he sinned against that. But I dare say even maybe the saints and angels in heaven, that when we sin, it touches, it ripples throughout the created universe. This is often hard for us to grasp, because we are, you know, by virtue of the culture we're born in, and the philosophy of this culture, materialistic and so forth, it's hard for us to think beyond ourselves, and that what we do affects anybody else, good or bad, you know. But then I Suppose we forget that the sin of Adam, one man's sin, spread to the whole human race. Thank you very much, Adam. St. Paul's teaching that when a Christian man joins himself to a harlot, he joins Christ and Christ's body to her as well. That doesn't fit very well with Western thinking, you know, individualistic thinking, but that's the Bible thinking. We are connected. We are a body. And when one member is sick, all the body is affected. I imagine the angels in heaven look down and wonder how, and it's really struggle, really to grasp, to understand how it is that man can be so selfish, so isolated, so individualistic in his thinking, as to suppose that, you know, what he does doesn't matter to anyone else, that it affects him and his life only. Well, that's not true. It's just not true. That's not what the scriptures or what the fathers teach. But fortunately, what's true of sin is also true of holiness, of goodness, of purity. Even one person praying, or doing a kindness, or staying clean and sober, or refusing to give in to the temptation to sin, can bring good not only to himself, but to so many around him. Do you believe that the prayers of the monks on Mount Athos half a world away affect you, touch you, maybe touch the world? Maybe the prayers of the faithful throughout have kept us from destroying ourselves. I mean, obviously God's grace and mercy mitigates our tendency to want to do that. But prayer has kept this world going and alive. It means really that we have only one acceptable way to live. And this was the simple little words that Jesus said when he began his ministry. We need to live in repentance, in light and life, and continual renewal in Christ. We need to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Way and his family, for Kevin and his family, for Stephanie, Sybil, Emily, for Bruce and his family, for Aaron and Sarah, Lauren, Ron, Judy, Wanda, Alicia, Keith, for the victims of the floods and mudslides of California, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Priya Lynn, on the 40th day of her repose, for the Korea Miriam, for Cheryl, Irene, Dorothy. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
Christ is in our midst.
He is in our midst.
My body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sin. Drink ye all of this. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sin.
With you all.
And with your spirit.
upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us and return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
Thank you. God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Thank you. Find notes to come forward or helping us to commemorate Maria Lynn on the 40th day anniversary of her repose and the recently reposed Maria Miriam, who we're also praying for. The choir will begin with the Spirit.
Thank you. Now and ever and unto ages of
part of this life, and that thou wilt pardon their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Do thou, the same Lord, give rest to the souls of thy departed servants, Cheryl, Irene, Dorothy, in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, which all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth in sin alone, and thou holy art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is Thou art the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy departed servants. For Cheryl, Irene, and Dorothy, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy fathers in everlasting, and thine awfully good and life-giving spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.